Here we go. 12 rounds of boxing, and introducing to you firstly, the challenger. Fighting out of the red corner, wearing the red trunks, trimmed with white, weighed in at 8 stone 5 pounds 3 ounces. An 18 fight record, 16 wins, 4 inside the scheduled distance, and just 2 defeats. The former European bantamweight champion from Liverpool, Ryan Fowler. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the champion. Fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black trunks, trimmed with silver, weighed in at 8 stone 5 pounds 6 ounces, with a perfect undefeated record of 14 contests, 14 wins, 9 inside the scheduled distance. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the WBC International Bantamweight Champion. He's the reigning and defending British Bantamweight Champion, making the first defense of the Lord Lonsdale's Challenge Belt from Belfast, Northern Ireland. Please welcome Ryan. So that's it, we're ready to go then. 12 rounds of boxing for the British Bantamweight Championship and the coveted Lord Lonsdale's Challenge Belt.
Okay, lads, obey my command. In the event of a knockdown, the fighter standing will go to the furthest neutral corner and stay there. Defend yourself at all times, touch gloves.
An excellent matchup for the venerable British Bantamweight crown, pitting the two Ryans together. There's Burnett of Belfast, Farag of here in Liverpool. Plenty of quality, grit, power as well in there. It should be a really enticing blend of styles in the 8 stone 6 division. Looking forward to this one.
I am. It is a real, it's an interesting fight to see whether the young prospect coming through, we can't really call him a prospect anymore because he's a champion, can actually come through this and show his potential, what he's been shown. He's got the makings of being a top-class fighter. But if anyone's going to ask questions of him, it's Ryan Farag.
A right hand from Farag early. He'll want to really take the fight to Burnett and not allow the Belfast protege some ring movement, mobility, chance to get set. His sharp, snappy punches, because he can be quality, Carl.
He can, yes. Straight away we're seeing Burnett, you know, he carries that power. Both his feet are flat to the ground, that back foot planted, and that's usually the signs of a power puncher. So, you know, if you can connect on Farag early on and make a dent, then that'll give him the confidence. He's British champion, he's unbeaten. Farag has tasted defeat, but he'll still be coming here confident with that extra experience, trying to upset the game plan of Burnett.
Working the body, Farag. Burnett with 9 knockouts in those 14 wins, but he's had to go a little bit longer in the last 3 fights. Jason Booth to win this belt. He had him down, Booth, a couple of times, but had to settle for the points win. Anthony Satoul and Cesar Ramirez in Leeds, which I think is the one you called, Paul.
Yeah, it was, and listen, he done well in the fight. It's a good right hand there from Farag. Just got through another one returned by Burnett. It's a good, fast, cagey start for both fighters.
Oh, nice shot to let go. Farag there. Picked that beautifully. Are we going to see Ryan Burnett really tested for the first time? That's what Farag says he'll do. He says, there's no pressure on me. I'm coming here as the underdog, even though it's my home city. It's a lively start, this, from Ryan Farag.
It was good work there from Farag. I mean, landed a couple of nice shots, then he smiled over at Burnett, who's on his back foot, looking sharp, looking strong, but taking shots. Landed a good right hand of his own there, Farag. But this fight is looking like an even fight early on.
No real feeling out process, but they're straight in, you know, but they're still a bit respectful, but they're really letting the big shots go from the belt.
They're both reddened already, and referee Bob Williams just watching like we all are as the action unfolds. Good work from Burnett, might just have the superior hand speed and sharpness, but Farag not afraid to let his own leather go. What a good opener.
Great opener. Liverpool fans behind Farag would be pleased with that.
Decide where you want to be.
Yeah.
If you're going to be making a move, that leg isn't sharp enough. Sharpen that front foot up. Or if you want to put it on him, then you know what you've got to do. Twitch him, put it on him, roll. No lunging. Make him show first. Do you understand? You understand?
Yeah.
Tell me what you're going to do in this round.
Gonna take that back step, make him throw, and right. Him.
So get this nice and sharp and be patient behind him.
Yeah.
Stinging and in low exit.
Yeah.
Water. Water, Rod.
Ryan Burnett with Adam Booth in the corner, who of course steered David Hay for much of his career, and George Groves. Good trainer, isn't he, Paul?
He's a good trainer, very good talker, and I don't mean saying the wrong things. I mean, he gets his point across eloquently and correctly and the way he wants to do things. I like the way his fighters fight. I like the style of his fighters, the way that, as Burnett's doing now, you know, little jinking here and there, little feints, waiting for movements, making you think that they're actually doing a lot of work, but they're not.
It's Paul and Mick Stevenson in the red corner of Ryan Farag, the 28-year-old in those red trunks, red boots. From here in Liverpool, Ryan Burnett from Belfast, but trains down in London. So much potential after a terrific amateur career that saw him win 94 of 98. Just out of range, though. Will he take risks here, Burnett, to make a statement? Because that's been the slight criticism of him, that he looked great in the first two or three rounds against Jason Booth, but it just drifted a bit. Excitement, entertainment.
Listen, this is exciting tonight. He's come out exciting. And he's come out meaning business, as has Farag, though it's not by any means a one-sided fight or a one-sided round. For the first one's a close round there. He's just...
I think you and Carl both had it level, didn't you?
Yeah, it's just all about picking the right shot for Burnett. You can see he's waiting, he's not rushing in too much. He's looking for the opener and he's trying to fiddle and fiddle about and confuse Farag and then come over the top with that right hand or the lead left hook. Farag's trying to get in close to let his own shots go.
Yeah, that's good work there from Burnett. Judging the distance, looking for the accuracy and range, and Farag short with his own jab. That's better from Ryan Burnett, who knows that Farag can be vulnerable. But Farag just deciding to apply pressure. Obviously believes he can break Burnett up and take him to places he hasn't been.
Yeah, dangerous fight for Burnett, because he's coming into Farag's backyard in Liverpool, and Farag's got nothing to lose. British towel here to grab hold of, to try and take from Burnett, and in front of his home crowd fans, and there's no pressure on him. He can just relax, and he looks like he's relaxing and enjoying it in there.
Yeah, very relaxed all week as Ryan Farag been. He's watched his Everton Red Triangle friends Jazza Dickinson, Kevin Satchel land the Lord Lonsdale Bell, and he wants a part of it as well. Got the opportunity, just catches his. Burnett walks into one. I think he's been hit more, Burnett, in these first couple of rounds than I've seen him so far in his career.
Yes, yeah, that type of fighter. I think he knew he was going to take a few shots in this fight because Farag's a very, very decent fighter.
I think the quality definitely lies with Burnett, but he just needs to take his time, find his feet, get into the fight. Very close early on, but it's a 12-round British title fight.
Now, here's the thing, we need you stepping right, that little bit more. It just forces him onto that side, takes his right hand away, which he loves, and forces him into moving away, doesn't want to move. So a little bit more stepping to the right from you, but your tactics are good, which is to come in, give it almost look like you're going to do the work, and then he can't wait, this kid, to jump in and land the shot. He's impatient. Let his impatience be his undoing, all right? So get close enough, and then when he comes in, the time counter, as he steps in, let him dig his own grave, right? You know what I mean? You need to be stepping right to do it and fading the jab the way you're doing. Do that. He can't stand to wait for you. He'll go before you will. Time him when he does. Good way. Good start.
Paul Stevenson, who was talking at him throughout that minute break, impressed with the beginning that his charge Ryan Farag has made as he challenges the British bantamweight champion Ryan Burnett, the 24-year-old, 4 years younger than Farag, here at the Echo Arena. Always looked a good one on paper, and it is bubbling up nicely.
Good fight on paper, good gel of styles as well, making for a nice fight. As you said, Burnett's probably been caught with more shots in this fight than his previous fight, which went a long time, and that's not a bad thing either. You know, this is the type of fight that he wants to be involved in at this type of level.
Tries the right hand, Burnett. Look at how wide he gets his legs as he tries to find the angles to confuse Farag. He's certainly got the skills there, the pedigree, the ability. But can he keep Farag off him, Carl?
Well, there's a confident-looking fighter. He's got that wide stance. He's got that confident look when he's in there. He's got the low hard held guard. The arms are low. That right hand looping right hook landed around the side of Farag's head. But Farag landed a nice counter right hand early on in this round. This is swaying back and forth. No one's really in control of this fight yet. They're both standing off. Farag seems a little bit more relaxed, but Burnett has that jittery, solid style where he looks like he's ready to throw a nice, dangerous counterpunch almost immediately.
And where have we seen that style before? Wired stance, Adam Booth fighters, David Hay, your mate George Groves. You know,
it's always
in a position to land that good counter right hand and also to get out of range fast as well and come back on the power shots.
Farag looking good though on his front foot. Burnett backed up on the ropes, landing body head shots. Burnett doesn't want to stay there for too long. He's British champion.
Doesn't want to be trapped in the corners, does he?
He doesn't know. You can get caught with shots. You've got nowhere to go when you're against the ropes or in the corner. You can turn off, but you can walk into a hook or a straight right hand or left hook, depending on which way you decide to go. You need to roll off them ropes as soon as your back foot gets. As soon as you feel that rope touch your back foot, you should be getting off the ropes. Nice little left hook counter there by Burnett.
Surprisingly, there's only four knockouts on Farag's record. But he did go to Belgium and beat Stéphane Germoy. That's a really good win in 9 rounds, stopping Germoy.
That is a surprising low knockout percentage because he does look like he can bang a bit. He looks capable punch-wise. But Burnett obviously holding the power of the two in this fight. And you can see
he's just loading up a little bit here, Farag. And he's trying a bit too hard to land the power shots. He just needs to get back to his jab, back to the basics again. Do what his corner was asking him to do, let Burnett commit and then try and counter him rather than trying to lead off with power shots.
Just feints there, trying to outthink each other. Concentration etched on the faces, goes for a body shot there. Farag, end of the third. Well, the challenger here is Ryan Farag. Ryan Burnett defending his British 8-stone-6 belt for the very first time, won it against the veteran from Nottingham, our old friend Jason Too Smooth Booth. What a great career Jason had, twin brother Nicky. Oh, good shots there from Ryan Burnett. Farag just in a haze, no knockdown, but he was spun around and just...
We saw something last week, Adam, in the Ricky Burns fight. Was it a knockdown? By the law of the land, that was a knockdown. The ropes have saved him. The referee was probably right doing a bit of common sense and using a bit of common sense and just waving it off and carrying on. But I think we'll have a few people talking about that one. Good combination from Burnett, though. Sharp, fast punching.
Yeah, that was good, wasn't it, that first?
Yeah, really was.
Farag didn't look hurt. I think momentum was against him and he lost his balance a bit. But you're right, Paul, a punch landed, he went over.
I think it's good work by the referee, a bit of common sense.
Finding his range now, Burnett, landed a good left hook there on Farag. And he took it well.
That's exactly what he's finding, Carl, is his range, the timing. That's a clever fighter. And he had a stacked amateur career. Irish youth champion, multi-nations.
Good little comeback from Farag, showing his stubbornness on the ropes.
Landed a couple of good shots on the ropes there, Farag. He took a couple in counter. It was a bit of a 50-50 tussle there and on the ropes. I think Burnett just got the better of it, and I think he's enjoying himself a little bit more. Starting to settle down now.
Bragg made the ABA featherweight final. So at the higher weight category, lost to Martin J. Ward. So both of them, good amateurs.
Got to keep that chin down. Farag, sorry, Adam's got to keep that chin down when he's throwing his jab. Throwing his jab and his chin's just drifting in the air.
Switching now, Burnett. The feeling is growing in confidence as he eases into this British title defence. Farag, just a bit clumsy as he goes forward. He's got to close it down sensibly, hasn't he, the range?
Yeah, he had a good bit of success earlier on when Burnett had his back to the ropes. Be nice if he can get Burnett there again, but you know, he landed a good jab also when Burnett was lunging in with his own attacks, and that's what Farag's corner's been asking him to do, you know, wait for him to commit and then counter.
Tries the uppercut, Ryan Farag. He got pretty good defence, Burnett. Farag believing that Burnett just hasn't had the experience as a pro, that he's operated at a higher level and that he'll find out as the rounds go by. Cheeky smile from Ryan Burnett. It's a good round for him.
Good round for him, but he's timing the jab nice. He's trying to think the jab, the body come over with the right hand. He's leading with a left hook a lot. He's throwing a good lead left hook. And it's typical, again, typical Adam Booth fighters, always setting traps. And he's always trying to make Ryan Farag walk onto one of them traps. Farag's getting a little bit frustrated and he's starting to lunge in a little bit, which he doesn't want to be doing.
You both score the first round level, and then you've got Burnett taking the next three.
Yeah, there's
three.
Not
so
much
getting
in the first round. I think Burnett's found his, exactly, getting into his groove. He's found his feet, he's planting, he's looking confident. But let's not forget, he's young. He's a young, unbeaten British champion.
And you know, tired to me, that kid.
That feeling, it feels good, but you're still growing in confidence. You still need to prove to yourself, if you like, that you belong there. And I think as this fight draws on and he starts to settle into it, which it looks like he already is, I think he'll take over.
And he has got experience as well, that 12 rounds with Jason Booth, Anthony Setoul in Manchester in February, then Cesar Ramirez in Leeds, third fight of 2016 for Ryan Burnett. Fourth fight of the year for Ryan Farag as they open up at the beginning of the fifth. And here comes Burnett. He did this at the start of the last round, and he's trying to posture. I think he was a bit annoyed. Maybe annoyed's the wrong word, but I think, you know, Adam Booth had given him the tactical plans to beat Jason Booth. He didn't want to sort of pull the trigger. I think Ryan wanted to, and I think he's desperate in there to sort of show something dramatic.
Of course, he'll want to win in style every time. Every time he gets in there, he's an exciting... I keep saying prospect, he's British champion, but he is a work in progress. He's a very, very good quality fighter in the making, Ryan Burnett.
But Adam Booth wants the wins, doesn't he? That's key to him. Remember what David Haye, you know, did out to Valoev?
Yeah, I mean, that was a great win tactically. But Burnett, like Paul said, he's still finding his feet. He's young, he's British champion, and he is a prospect. You're right to call him a prospect, Paul, even though he's British champion. We want to be world champions as professionals. Yeah. We want to get to the world title level. And he's very much a prospect on the world scene. So he needs to close this show.
Planting his feet more, whipping in body shots now. Ryan Burnett's taking the fight to Ryan Farag. It's a shift in the plot.
He's come out spiteful this round. Adam, you're very correct. He's come out head forward, trying to plant his head against Ryan Farag's head. And he's banging away to the body. He's throwing nice uppercuts up to the head to bring the elbows in and then swinging him round to the side as well. Come out really mean a business this round.
Yep, very changed. Minute and a half or so in this round from Ryan Burnett. Ryan Farag on the retreat. And if you could back him up, there's a little bit of damage under that left eye. He's trying to march him down and soften him to the body. This is good work from Ryan Burnett. And a lovely left hook to the liver and an uppercut following. We're starting to see why people rate him so highly.
Yes, great work there from Burnett. Farag on his back foot, more experience, 4 years. He's senior, more fights under the belt, but can't seem to cope with this pressure of Burnett when he's pushing forward with his shots, body in the head. He looks solid, he looks strong, very impressive.
Farag really, Burnett really turning the screw on Farag here. He's really putting the pressure on this round. This has been the biggest, the widest round so far to score.
It's a real drive as well from Burnett, who was happy just to utilise his flashier skills in the early sessions, but now planting the feet, digging in the shots, particularly effective to the body, switching upstairs. It's the biggest round of the fight so far for Ryan Burnett. And Ryan Farag caught in a haze.
Very good. Take your breath, lean forward. Nice deep breath. Okay? Comfortable. Feel comfortable. Take a deep breath.
Certainly, it was a heavy round in favour of Burnett the fifth as he shakes his head and postures, and he's starting to catch Farag more now. And there's a ragged appearance, Carl, isn't there, suddenly, to Ryan Farag?
There is, yeah, and that's partly, well, mainly due to the fact that Burnett is landing some nice, accurate shots from out of range as well. I'm quite impressed with his style and the way he's lunging in with some of these range, out of range shots from the support and the orthodox. So he's tricky, he's awkward, and he's a bit of a puncher, so he'd be a nightmare to be in front of. And as he grows in confidence, and if he can get through this and defend his British title, you know, the future looks very bright for this young prospect, Burnett. He's doing well here to defend his title against a tricky experience Farag, who's coming on here and putting pressure on Burnett.
Farag with body shots and a smile from Burnett, as if to say, okay, come on then, let's have this.
I think Farag, when he was welcomed in there, probably didn't want to do as he was told, so to speak, didn't want to engage in Burnett's type of fight, but it would have been good for him to back Burnett up there and take the momentum away.
Is this the second half of the fight, the change in style that Adam Booth was asking for at this sort of stage in the round, as maybe Farag does tire? Interesting to see if Ryan Burnett unleashes a volley up close now.
Fascinating listening to Cornaway, and I always like listening in. It's good to hear what the top trainers in the country are saying.
Oh, good left lovely left hook, body shots as well. Farag answers with a couple, and he's wild there, Burnett, but he certainly had an effect on Farag, who's brave, but just wilts on the shoulders of Ryan Burnett. He's feeling some of these inside the last minute of the sixth. Swapping uppercuts.
Really looking for that left hook to the body, Burnett. Touching a right uppercut in and then swinging the left hook round to the body.
And he's landing those body shots. And this is phase two of the round. That's what Adam Booth asked for. Ryan Farag, can he get himself off those ropes?
He's got to show a little bit more variety here, Burnett. He's signing the left hook all the time. Maybe touch up with your left uppercut, come round with a right hook to the body.
Good uppercut from Farag on the inside. Doesn't want to go quietly here, Ryan Farag. So much pride in front of his home fans. Trying to get through this rather difficult patch in the fight. Come back with shots of his own, Farag, as it really hots up in there.
That's right, Adam. He's hooking up tightly and answering back nicely. He's not going away just yet. And Burnett getting really confident, a little bit over-eager, I think. Hopefully he can maintain this, or he may start to think to himself, I wish I took my foot off the gas a little bit. Really pressure there by Burnett. Good round for him.
Excellent action. Have a look at what people are saying out there on the front
nice
foot, going looking for Farag. That's absolutely right, getting in close. Best young and up-and-coming boxer in the UK will go all the way. That's what people are telling us, the gym rats, people that have worked with him, and he does indeed look a class act.
And that's what we mean when we keep saying prospect. We mean, you know, he's an up-and-coming fighter. Good body shot there from Farag. This is where Farag should have tried to maybe keep his foot on the gas a little bit more and keep Burnett with his back to the ropes, because we saw in the latter part of the round there, once Burnett was on the front foot and Farag had his back to the ropes, it was, you know, he was teeing off, he was finding shots, and it was just a matter of time before he found that angle, which he's still looking for.
Second half of this British bantamweight title, the champion, Ryan Burnett, in the black with the silver of his name etched on the waistband and the all red and white of Ryan Farag. Ryan Burnett must be in a very handy lead now. He showed some real class punches, but Farag staying with him and trying his best, trying to find a way to hurt the Irishman. easier said than done, I guess, Paul.
It is. It's easier said than done. You've got to try and stop him in his tracks, and then you've got to try and back him up and make him, well, take him out of his rhythm and out of his stride, which he's certainly in at the minute. He's looking comfortable. Carl said before, he switches so well to southpaw and looks very comfortable as a southpaw as well, but he doesn't stay there too long, which I like. He gets right back to business and tries to break him down as an orthodox.
Drag wielding in the hooks. Only two defeats on the record, one to Lee Haskins, that was in Prize Fighter, so don't read too much into that. And then the stoppage in three rounds in June in Liverpool to Karim Gwerfi. He was hurt badly by that.
Nice body shot from Farag as well. Just got to stop loading up Farag. He's looking for big power shots all the time, and he's tensing up, and it's making them slow. He's got to just touch a few light ones in and whip one round. Just try letting some fast shots go first, just to land on the target rather than going for full-blown power every time.
Really good fight for Burnett, British champion here, in against somebody like Farag, who's solid, experienced, up for a fight, and answering back with shots. It's giving Burnett plenty to think about in there, but Burnett in control, but not easy for him.
Looking for the uppercut again, Farag. He's full of fire and energy still.
This is where he needs to have a go back now, Farag. He's just took a little sustained attack on the ropes with his back to the ropes. He needs to get time, answer back now to Burnett and have a little bit more of his say as well.
Has he quite got the skill set and the speed, though, to get through? That's better from Farag with the body work. And Burnett says, come on then, let's give some entertainment to the crowd. I think that's what Burnett really wanted to do tonight. I think he's been hurt a little bit about the sort of dullness of some of his wins. I think he wanted to put on a showcase here, and it's certainly a very good fight to watch.
A good little spell for Farag. Again, the stubbornness kicking in. He's a dangerous fighter himself, and he will be dangerous until the final bell.
Just trying to blast through the defence of Farag, though. Burnett, when he traps him on the ropes, Carl, that's where he has good success.
It is, yeah. Farag had a bit of success there, a bit of good success. He was happy with it, but Burnett just smiled in acknowledgement, turns it around, and he's got Farag backed up, landing classy-looking body and headshots, putting the pressure on him here. Burnett looking strong.
Must have heard you, Paul, because he landed a right hook to the body as well. That was a bit of variety from Burnett. Farag still holding on. Let's find out how Johnny and Ed are seeing things.
Well, Farag is brave and defiant, Johnny, but what do you make of Burnett's tactics, how he can change them during a round, going forward, then going back, and then...
I'm so impressed by Burnett. I've seen a side to him that I didn't know existed, I'd heard about, but this kid can box fight, well on the back foot, then all of a sudden puts the pressure on offensively and defensively, switches southpaw without you even realising midway through a round. But he's so strong, feels comfortable walking for right down, tucking up, blocking his shot, and pushing him back. And it's like he's playing with him. So as the rounds roll on, when most fighters get a little fatigued and they want to get a respite, he seems to get more hungry as the rounds go on. And he smiles, lets the shots go. He opens his eyes, he finds the spots, blocks the shots, walks down to the back off. And he's very comfortable doing it. That is skill. That is wisdom.
Thank you, Johnny.
Skill and wisdom. I think we're all liking the look of Ryan Burnett. He was worried about the previous fights, that the opponents were, you know, afraid to maybe throw their own shots. They covered up in shells, and he wanted somebody like Ryan Farag to bring the best out of him. I think that's a good point.
Very good point. A lot of fighters out there like fighters coming at them. You know, certain fighters, you'll have a field day where you'll feed off their leads. You'll really enjoy the fact that they're coming at you to throw, because you can try and break them down mentally.
On his back foot, Burnett, I'm impressed. Even when he's against the ropes, if you look on the slow motion replays between the rounds, his eyes are fixed on his opponent. He's looking directly ahead. He's blocking shots and counter punching without too much concern on what's coming at him. And it's unusual for a young man, 24 years old, to have that kind of confidence.
Interesting you mention that, young at 24. A real maturity to Ryan Burnett. He's come down from Ireland to South London. We had him around the Sky Studios a few months ago, and you know, he's just got a pretty wise head on those shoulders. And I'm sure linking up with Adam Booth, he's got Andy Lee in the Jim Mitchell Smith now as well. He'll be learning so much. Farag trying to dig in and try and unlock Burnett and have some sort of an impact, but it's just not really working.
The maturity you're talking about with Burnett, he's only 24. He's still got to sort of fill out and have that man strength come as well, which is a little bit of a frightening prospect because he will get stronger, but he's the bully in this fight here. He's the one who's taking control strength-wise. Out of all the exchanges, he's coming out on top of the majority of them.
He's got very strong legs for a bantamweight as well. Ryan Bananas, Ryan Farag unloads. He's still putting so much commitment in. Farag, he wants this so badly, this British title, but Bennett just driving the punches home. Here again, the second half of the round, as he elects to get right up close and personal.
Good little counter left hook there from Farag, but he's not getting the power and the leverage in it that he should be getting because he's back to the ropes.
That body shot was clean as well, that one. He just couldn't get out of the way of it, Ryan Farag, but look at this grit and determination coming back with shots. There's no fold, there's no quit. He's digging in here, Farag, really deep, because he's in with a class act.
Digging in well there at him, and he's landing some shots, having some success, but Bennett just walks through him, gives him a little grimace, through a smile, so he takes his shot, he feels it, but he answers back. And that's why I'm so impressed with Bennett, because whether he's on his front foot, as we're seeing now, landing shots pretty much at will, landing lovely body shots there, left hook, right hook to the head, uppercuts through as well, or whether he's on his back foot, he's blocking, he's got a great defence and he's counter-punching.
I wonder if this is another draining round for Ryan Farag. He's had to soak up so much, and those body shots have got to be having a toll, haven't they, Paul?
They have, and if he just lengthens his arm a little bit more and gets it a little bit wider, he'll have a little bit more success.
What fitness, what heart from Ryan Farag. Another round in the bank, though, for Ryan Bennett. He's becoming a really good-looking fighter in front of our eyes, round after round here, Carl.
The longer this fight goes on for Bennett, the more maturity and the more skill and different areas of skill level I'm seeing. On his front foot, he's landing accurate, nice, sharp body and headshot. But when he's on his back foot, as I said earlier, he's got his eyes fixed on his opponent. He's blocking and then counter-punching with confidence. And that's unusual for a young man, 24 years old, to come into the ring with that kind of pedigree.
What have you seen, Paul, that's different to other young fighters?
What I've seen that's different to Bennett's last performance and a few before that is the spitefulness in him. I'm really liking his spiteful streak, what I can see. He's coming forward and he's bullying Farag most of the time now. He's pushing forward. He's not showing much respect to what's coming back to him because he knows he's the boss and he's in charge at the minute.
The crowd really beginning to fill up. Lucky ones who've got in early, because this is a really good fight for the British bantamweight title. Ryan Bennett might be winning the rounds, but Ryan Farag winning the hearts. He's been so courageous. He's still in there. He's still trying desperately to find something that will just unnerve Ryan Bennett. Remember, Luke Campbell and Derry Matthews. Could be an absolute cracker, that one coming up. And Tony Bellew and BJ Flores. I love these Liverpool nights, Paul.
And me. And the Liverpool fighters just had a good little exchange and attack there against Bennett. Landed with a couple of shots, come forward. This is really, he needs to try and keep that momentum in his favour, Ryan Farag. Keep the pressure on Bennett, stop the momentum.
Farag's got a good attitude, he means business. He didn't want to touch gloves there at the start of the round. I think Bennett was looking to say sorry for the late punch on the bell in the last round, but Farag having none of it. I think with the best will in the world from Farag, I just don't think he's good enough, but he's making for a good fight. Great experience for Bennett being involved.
The Stevenson brothers in Farag's corner, willing him in. But again, he's backed up by this terrific Ryan Bennett.
That left hook to the body from Bennett. He needs to just let his arm go a little bit more, get a bit more distance on it, open it up a bit wider. He's pulling it. He's just pulling a bit too short on it, in the elbow every time.
Nice right hand to the head, left to the body. Variety. Back comes Farag with a couple of uppercuts. Look at this.
Great
for
chance.
A stand from Ryan Farag.
Farag's not just going to go away, Adam. He's in there and he means business. He wants to do himself proud, not just his
body city. Shot, wicked one. That one from Ryan Bennett. After Farag did all that good work and he's having the last answer, Bennett. That's the problem for Farag.
This is where Farag doesn't want to be. See the position he's in on the ropes. He can't generate no power in his own shots.
Not much power in his counter punches, you're right there.
Just
Paul, the weight's against
him. Left foot a little bit, isn't it? And just widen your stance forward a little bit.
But he's resilient, he wants to fight back, he's sitting on the ropes, he's tucking up tight, but Bennett just too much for him here.
He's game, he's brave, he's looking for the big counters as well, but he just needs to
He's mauling game, Paul. It's an absolutely astonishingly brave effort, this, from Ryan Farag. He really is. These British title fights bring something out in you guys. They really do. And Ryan Burnett seems on the verge, you know, round after round, but Farag finds something from somewhere. Can he keep this going? Can he sustain it? At the end of the ninth round, as Burnett attacks again.
I think Burnett can sustain it. He looks comfortable. He doesn't look like he's forcing anything. Okay, his shots look quite stiff and a little bit loaded up at some time to the body, but he looks relaxed, he looks confident.
Another body shot, this time to the right side.
Burnett looking well, seemed to be closing the show nicely in his latter part of the fight, which he needs to do as champion. But the defiance of Farag, let's see what he's got left.
It's the right word for it, Carl, defiance and stubbornness. You know, he really is defiant. He won't go down easily, he won't go down without a fight. Although it's been, you know, the majority of the rounds have been going in Burnett's favour, he's certainly making a fight of it.
Right hand from Burnett. Excellent action, it's been all the way through. Bob Williams has hardly had to do anything. It's been a really good watch, this. Are we seeing the development of a star in Ryan Burnett, who desperately wants to fight in Belfast, top of show there? Obviously, Carl Frampton has had so much success in the last couple of years, finishing in that amazing win against Leo Santa Cruz, two-weight champion and an inspiration, I know, to Ryan Burnett. Body shots. But again, Farag comes forward.
I think Burnett now just needs to not do anything silly, just keep moving like he is doing, picking his shots nicely. But I think as British champion, as a rising prospect, a rising star, you do want to close the show and you do want to look like the grandstand finisher. So we'll probably see a bit more from Burnett as these last couple of rounds close in.
Farag really needs to put his foot down here and steal this round, because Burnett's taking the round off, he's backing off, he's trying to still win the round, although he's taking a blow, he's on the back foot. It's a good opportunity for Farag to really stamp something on this fight.
I think Farag knows he's been beaten though, Paul. I think, yeah, you know, for him to push on his front foot, he's going to walk into shots.
I'm just going to ask you that, Carl. Do you know, as fighters in there, I mean, you had that the difficult one with Andre Ward, and Paul, you've had a few. Do you know when someone's just that bit too good for you, and you feel it's going away?
You do. You know when it's difficult. You know you're going to have to really, you know, you're going to struggle. You're going to have to put your foot on the gas. But we saw from Farag, he landed two good right hands as he was talking, and it was quality work from Farag. But Burnett answered straight back. He's still working away here, Farag, and this is very good. This is what we're allowed to see. This is intentional, and he's looking good. And Burnett will learn a lot from this, but you don't want to be on the end of too many of these, Adam.
Yeah, toe-to-toe action, phone box stuff. Ryan Farag coming on strong. Back comes Burnett, though. Again, does he have the last answer?
That's my point, what I said about he really needs to do something this round, because he's not going to win this fight on points. He's far too behind on everyone's scorecard. He's going to win by landing a sneaky body shot or a big head shot as Burnett unload. He nearly needs to put his foot on the gas here and make sure he gets this round.
Well, he did that there.
He turn it in his favour.
He did that right there. Hand from Ryan Burnett. Just snap the head back of Ryan Farag, and he's caught in another right hand. Coming towards the end of the round, and Ryan Farag, having had a good one, is just in a spot of bother here. He's falling all over, Ryan Burnett.
I think he's in danger of emptying the tank here, Adam, with that work he had, that quality work.
I'll tell you what, emptying the tank, these two have obviously put so much into their training camps. Fitness personified.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, great round from Farag. I'd like to score that round for Farag, because
go on, then.
He landed some great shots. But Burnett was still very much in that fight, in the round, even though he was on the end of some tasty-looking shots.
You've given it to Farag. And interestingly, that's the first round you've given to Ryan Farag. And it's sort of a shame, that, isn't it? It's right, but it's a shame.
It is. And listen, we were talking about scoring after last week's fight, and we're saying, you know, you can have 12 very close rounds, but one fighter nicks them all and just shades them all. And it's a wide-scoring fight. The rounds haven't been completely one-sided, dominated by Ryan Burnett. Farag has been in the fight, he has been making a very good argument of it, but I feel Burnett just had the better class in most of the rounds. But that was a very good round for Ryan round Farag, 11. And if he hasn't emptied the tank, then he needs to go and try and get another one of them.
Well, Steve Gray from Fleetwood, Ian John Lewis just in front of us from Gillingham, and a Victor Loughlin from Barrhead are the three judges. I shouldn't think there'll be any real differences in the cards. Ryan Burnett by a country mile, but Ryan Farag is still there, and he's got 6 minutes to try and turn this around and not be remembered for what was a fantastic, gritty, defiant effort. He's never had Burnett in real trouble, has he?
No, he's landed a few good shots, he's landed sneaky counters here and there, and he's certainly, you know, stubborn and defiant, as Carl said before, but he's never really had Burnett in a position where we've had to worry.
Lovely counter punch there from Burnett on his back foot. Farag still having a go late on here, but Burnett just too much in the toolbox for him. Nice timed counter right hand.
And he's got blood from the nose as well, Ryan Burnett. He's learned a few things in there tonight, experience-wise as well. Mixing up the styles and taking the fight to Farag when he's needed to, and using his skill set in other parts of the rounds. Back comes Farag.
We can't dismiss Farag as well. I mean, Farag can come again, he's a great fighter, but he's got too much in front of him in Burnett here. Burnett's real quality, he's shown some real quality slick move tonight. He's strong and solid right through here to round 11. He's still pushing forward, landing shots.
Well, I'm sure he wants the stoppage, he wants the dramatic finish, and if Ryan Farag opens up and goes for it himself, which surely he needs to do on the cards, then maybe that will give Burnett the opportunity, unless Farag's just happy staying with him until the final.
That's the danger with Farag, opening up, emptying the tank and then getting stopped, which he nearly did that in round 10. I mean, he had a great round, but now he seems to be running on empty in survival mode.
As daft as it sounds, Carl, he doesn't deserve to get stopped, does he? He deserves to see the final bell. He's put up a very good performance here. I know in boxing no one probably deserves much, but you have to take your hat off to what he's done tonight. He's dug in, he's really showed a lot of doggedness to stay in this fight, and he deserves something from it.
Something about these Lonsdale belts that bring out the best. I was with Jamie Moore earlier, and we were remembering about the Matthew Macklin fight, and, you know, Alex Arthur and Michael Gomez. Alex was with us last week. Those, they just stick out in the memory as much as any world title fights. The Lonsdale belt is special. It's really special for you guys, isn't it?
It is. Some of the best fights I've seen have been for the British title. One of the best fights I've ever seen live was Michael Gomez against Alex Arthur. The next one was probably Jamie Moore against Matthew Macklin. You know, two absolute barnstormers.
You should have the top two fighters in that weight division in Britain. And, you know, what Brits can fight. So we expect a good fight for the British title.
Firm. Sit down. Sit down. Lean forward. Lean forward. 1 second. Take your breath. Take your breath. 12th and final round. 12th and final round. Nice deep breath. Nice deep breath. You want to be a champion?
Yeah.
You want to be a champion?
What do you want me to do?
I want you to dominate. Start sharp for 30 seconds, give nothing away, break him, clean, break him. But when you go inside, do not let him get off. Give him nothing long, give him nothing short. I want him to break his will.
Okay.
You understand?
Okay.
Deep breath.
Do you want to be a champion?
Championship round, let's go now.
I think he's shown us he's a very worthy champion.
Second
tonight
for the 12th and final round
in the Echo Arena here in Ryan Farag's hometown of Liverpool. It's the last throw of the dice for the local boy, the challenger for Ryan Burnett's British title. Can Farag do something extraordinary late? We've seen it in boxing before, but the odds are stacked well against him. Ryan Burnett has looked super sharp and very, very good indeed.
Clash of heads there. You saw that the boot saying in the corner then, you know, do you want to be a champion? I think there's no danger of the result here, but I think he wants Burnett to go out and put a performance on. He's a nice man, Adam Booth, but he's a spiteful man as well with his fighters. He wants them to really turn the screw and put a performance on him. But, you know, break the will of the opponent all the time.
It's amazing how many body shots Farag has had to take. You my question. Possibly, maybe, whether there's something a little bit lacking in the power department of Burnett. Maybe, but it's so difficult to give him any sort of criticism on a night like this. He's been wonderful to watch, and he really is a blossoming fighter. And another one from Ireland to really get behind and keep our eyes on. Smashing guy outside the ring as well.
After the commentators on his last fight, I spotted a few little faults, and tonight I haven't spotted much at all. He's working all the time, he's improving all the time. You know, tonight the only fault I'm seeing is something so trivial as in the position of his left hook to the body when it lands. You know, it's really nitpicking. He's doing very well.
Good left hook to the head. Any drama late? I agree with you guys. I think Ryan Farag well and truly deserves to hear the final bell. But Ryan Burnett will try something late on, surely. That's what Adam Booth wanted.
Farag can see the shots. He's just fatigued now and beyond, you know, beyond the in the condition to land them.
He's come out in round 12, Burnett. He's dominated from start up until now, and he probably will until the finish. Because not just because Farag's fatigued, which he is, but because, you know, his work's of that kind of quality. His defence is good, he's picked his gloves up now. Burnett close, he's not really landing any shots. Marching forward and landing the
shots. Still Ryan Farag throws the body shots with 30 seconds left of the 12th. It's been a sterling effort from the Liverpool man, but it's been a real classy display from the Irishman, who whips in a right hand. It's another really good engaging battle, albeit a little bit one-sided in the rounds. But I tell you what, the ferocity in there and the spirit shown has been an absolute pleasure, and they both deserve huge respect.
Still firing back there, Farag, he points out nicely right until the end. Taking shot, but still having to go himself. Got to give him massive credit for great work from Burnett all the way through. And a deserved British champion, deserved winner.
12 excellent rounds. Ryan Burnett will remain the British bantamweight champion. Ryan Farag will come again. It was a terrific challenge, and there's no disgrace in falling short to a man of the pedigree and quality of Ryan Burnett.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of championship boxing, the judges' scorecards read: Steve Gray 118-111, Ian John Lewis 117-111, and Victor Lachlan 118-110. And all three judges are in favour of the winner. And still, the British bantamweight champion and the holder of the Lord of Lonsdale's challenge belt from Belfast, Northern Ireland, Ryan Burnett!
You happy with that performance overall?
Yeah, I'm happy with the performance. My past few fights have been, it's been sort of boxing, and I wanted to prove to everyone that I can fight. So I stood in there and had a bit of a scrap.
Farag was very brave, wasn't he? Defiant all the way through. Was it important for you to be in an exciting fight this evening?
I needed it, I think. I needed something like that where people watched and was like, wow, I want to see that kid again. So it was the perfect fight for me. And Ryan Farag, geez, he was hard as nails. I was hitting him and thinking to myself, please go away. But he wouldn't.
Ryan, it's been many years since I've seen such a potentially talented fighter like yourself. Is that the kind of fight you needed to bring the best out? Is there more to come?
And I definitely needed that. I needed someone to test me, someone to hurt me. And that's exactly what I got. I've got a lip the same size as his afro. So it's good. I needed it.
Well, tonight, we'll let you get off. Very exciting performance.